Hello, it's Asian American female serial killer. They'll never catch me because we all look the same. Shut the fuck up, Scott Peterson. I don't care if Dean Cain, who played you in a Lifetime movie, was part Asian. I'm allowed to say that you're not. How'd you even get on this forum from Death Row? I'm like genuinely asking because that's like really nice and we should all take note just in case. Hold on a second. Pardon my disguise. I left my usual murdering kimono at my mom's house and she's over 70, so obviously I've been staying away. It's been a pretty tough time out there to be a serial killer because, well, it's not safe to kill people right now. The virus has really affected our plans, huh? Hey, I hope my fellow Night Stalkers are hanging in, and I am so appreciative of this group and so thankful to the dark web for allowing us to gather. It's important, especially right now. Man, I don't think I'm the only one who's noticed how codependent our pets have gotten during the pandemic, right? I mean, don't get me wrong. I enjoy the company, and Sarah Jessica Barker's presence really does alleviate the loneliness. But I do wonder how she's going to cope when I have to go back to killing again. Or I guess I should say if I ever get to go out killing again. All right. There you go. Go ahead. Oh, man. It really seems like it's been years since I stalked that white bitch Taylor who called me a chink at Trader Joe's. Crushed her skull with a block of her own frozen cauliflower rice and dragged her to my dark lair. We're just all panic shopping then, unaware of what the future holds. But one thing was for sure, Taylor was a fucking racist little cunt who crossed the line, and I really hope that my Asian Americans are hanging in there, you know, with a rise of hate crimes against us and everything. It's scary. Oh, and if any of my people are watching, I cannot reiterate this enough. I only kill white people. I love you, Scott. I'm not talking to you. You will never be Asian, so stop fucking commenting. However, I really don't mean to speak in the antiquated rhetoric of us versus them right now. Not to be a pandering bitch like Andrew Yang's op-ed, but I know there are a lot of serial killers out there of all races who are awesome. I mean, let's be honest. Jack the Ripper, one of my personal heroes. Jack was most definitely Caucasian, though probably a woman, as a man wouldn't have that much expertise around a uterus. I personally like to think that Jack, the female, surgically removed the uteruses from bad women and implanted them into deserving, infertile couples while they were sleeping. Think like reverse tooth fairy, but with uteruses. Ugh, God, it's been so great seeing your faces and catching up a little. I know I've talked too much and Jared Leto is dying to share next, but I just want to say one last thing. I noticed that a lot of us have been arguing amongst each other on various forums, on variations of insular topics like whether or not we should be digitally stalking our marks right now instead of thinking of ways to improve how we do it live, or if internet violence is the same as actual violence, and if it's ruining the art of murder, et cetera, et cetera. And I know nobody asked for my opinion, but I do think that right now we are all vulnerable. And I think it's safe to say we're all a little scared, or at least a little disappointed that we aren't doing the thing we dedicated our lives to, loved the most, and probably sacrificed a lot for. I personally know a lot of serial killers whose families don't approve of their chosen paths. Many have to keep it a secret and pretend to be bankers or experimental theater artists. Hell, most serial killers I know have two or three jobs just so they can afford to kill, and God knows. Unless you're already fighting for it and your family, none of us is doing this for the money. But the one thing we all have in common is a love for murder. I try to remember that. It really does help me get through the day because, man, as long as we have love, we will always be able to kill, no matter what. So in the meantime, I don't know if you want to upload videos of yourself stabbing and then degrading naked Barbie dolls on X-Videos, or leave anonymous / subliminal threats on your next victim's TikTok or whatever, because it makes you feel like a murderer in a time where murdering is even harder to do than it normally is. I say go for it. As imperfect as it may be, it's still harassment. Unwanted content in the digital sphere is still unwanted content. And unwanted content is at the root of what we do. But if you don't want to do anything, I think that's okay too. I really do think everything's gonna be okay, guys, even if it's not okay. I read that once in a Hallmark card. But I think it's true, because as heartbreaking as it can be, come on, we can't all get the same kind of attention as Ted Bundy. Murder gives people a purpose. So as long as we're breathing, we'll find a way. And please remember that your desire, your frustration, your anger and grief of not being able to fully be who you are right now is just the light inside of you glowing, waiting to illuminate the world. Shut the fuck up, Taylor! Man, I was saving her for a rainy day, but maybe it's time I go shut her up. There is a special place in hell for dumb bitches who blame the pandemic on Asian Americans. Oh, and by the way, this white girl is not Tay-Tay Swift. I love you, Tay-Tay. If you're ever on the dark web, hit a girl up. All right. Wipe that down. I have a bottle of disinfectant somewhere.